Welcome back to Power BI Helpline. Today, we will talk about auto-expand columns in Power BI, and we will look into the M code power of Power Query. If you are new to the channel, then please subscribe and hit the bell icon to get notified. With that, let's check it out. Okay, so in this folder, I have Excel files for country-wise sales, and if I want to append all these into one single data set, I can simply use the folder path. And from Power BI Desktop, I can choose Folder Connector to combine and load into a single dataset. It is very quick and easy in Power BI. But as that you can see here, it needs a sample file to do all the required transformations. And here is a problem, which we will solve today. So, we got all our files appended in a single table. The problem here is, if you will add any other column only to the first file which was taken as the sample, it will show automatically with the refresh. But if you will add extra columns to any other files in your folder, it won't show up here with the refresh. I have added an extra column to my first file Canada, and now I am refreshing it from my Power BI Desktop. As that you notice here, the added column test new column 1 is added automatically here. Now let's add a column to another Excel file, and see if that is also showing here. I am adding one column with a name, test new column 2 in my Germany file. This column will not be visible into Power BI, because this was not the part of sample file. Let's jump into the Power Query Editor and see why it is happening and how to solve this. As that you can see, Power Query has generated all the required functions and transformations with the help of the sample file Canada, and it will not add columns automatically from other files. I am going to delete all these steps. And I will write my own M code to dynamically accept any extra columns from any of the files in my folder. I have deleted all those steps, and I am left with the source step. Now from Advanced Editor, I will add my first column, which will extract the contents from the Excel files. For this, I will use two M code functions. One is table.addColumn, and another is excel.workbook. To add this column, you can also use the GUI. But since I need to add two more columns like this, I want to show it all at one place, so that it will be easy to understand. Since this is Excel workbook, it will have many objects, and I need to expand this all content column, and only keep the data column, and rest all can be deleted. As that you can see, our data is only inside this columns tables. I will delete all other columns. In that columns are starting from second row, so now I will add my second last column, which is promote headers. The M code for adding columns will be same, but only thing I need to change is the last function, which will be applied to each of these tables, and that function is table.promoteheaders. So, I have mentioned the column name is promoted, and then will mention table.promoteheaders. After this, I will apply only one more step, and our solution will accept any number of new columns from any of the files in my folder. Alright. So I got my tables with promoted header, I need only this column, and then I will add my final column to combine all these tables into one single table. So the step name I am mentioning here is final output. And I am using table.combine function, inside that I need to pass the previous steps as table and the column name. Now we are ready with our solution. We can close and apply from Power Query. After applying these steps, your Power BI report will accept any additional column from any of the file in your folder in case you have appended multiple files into one. To test this, I am adding test new column 3 into my Mexico file, and you will see this column will automatically show in my Power BI after refreshing the dataset. Since this column is only in Mexico file, I can select country Mexico here, and will see the numbers in the extra column. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe to our channel for more such interesting solutions in Power BI.